Today's topic for discussion is reproduction in neatum. Let us see the male strobilus of neatum first. The sporophyte of neatum is dioecious and it bears male and female reproductive organs on separate plant because it is dioecious. And the plant may be tree or shrub or woody climber, but it is dioecious plant. The reproductive organs are organized into well-defined cones or strobili. The cone is also known as strobilus. These strobili are organized into well-defined inflorescence, which are usually panicle type of inflorescence that arise singly or in fascicles in leaf axils from the axis of the leaf. They may also be terminal. The inflorescence may be terminal in position. Okay. The cones arise in the axils of paired and decussate scale leaves. These leaves are fused at their bases to form a boat-shaped structure. They are also called bracts. The bracts bear the auxiliary or accessory buds that may develop into new inflorescence in addition to the strobilus. Okay, let us see all the details of male strobilus of neatum. Neatum, it is a gymnospermic plant. Let us see the male strobilus or male cone of the neatum. The male cone of neatum that consists of an elongated axis that is clearly distinguishable into nodes and internodes. The internodes are very short in young cone. The nodes of the axis bear scaly bracts arranged in whorls. These nodal bracts fuse together to form a cup-like structure which is called as cupule or a collar. Cupule or collar. So, every node of the axis bear a collar of fused bracts. The number of collars correspond to the number of nodes on the cone axis, and usually this number varies between 10 to 20, 25. Each collar bears above it 3 to 6 rings of male flowers, each ring representing a number of male flowers. This is the neatum plant and this is the male strobilus of neatum. The male flower in the rings are arranged alternately. Above the rings of the male flower, there is one ring of abortive female flowers or ovules. These are abortive. In rare cases, for example, in Neatum africanum, the ovules in this ring may be fertile so that the cone becomes bisexual. The cones looks very compact in a young state, but as the internode elongates, the collars separate from each other. In case of Neatum ulla, the apical region of male cone is bare or naked. The young male cone is completely enveloped within the basal bracts that are conate at base. Later the male cone grows and emerges out of the fused bract. It is extremely compact at this stage. The collars are also contain sclerites of various shapes and sizes. Laticiferous tubes are also present in the collars and the axes. Each male flower elongated. Each male flower is elongated within a perianth that appears sheath-like. It consists of a stalk that bears two anthers at its apex. Each anther has a single locule or a microsporangium. At maturity and a little before rehiscence, the stalk elongates and projects beyond the perianth. At this stage, anthers and the stalk are visible outside the perianth, as shown in the photograph. The male flowers are interspersed with uniseriate and multicellular hair. The perianth of the male flowers also consists of sclerites that may be very small in size or become profusely branched and star-shaped. Branched or unbranched latex tubes have also been reported in the perianth lobes. These latex tubes contain latex. Latex, it is a milky substance. Some variations have also been reported in the male flowers. This is about the male strobilus of Neetam. This photograph is the male strobilus of male cone of Neetam nemon.